Okay, Aki Karim here from BBTV. I'm delighted this morning to be joined on the Zoom by Asif Vali, who, if you follow boxing, of course, you'll know Asif from over the years. But I believe you're also now stepping into a new venture, which we're going to talk about with Fight Zone. Asif, great to have you with us. Just before we talk about Fight Zone, of course, there's a massive fight coming up with somebody you know very closely in Amir Khan, a big fight with Kell Brook. Are you excited for the fight?
I think the fight itself is exciting. Is the timing right for the fight? We don't know. I think everybody knows that it's a bit late. 3 years ago would have been perfect. 5 years ago would have been better. It would have been a fantastic story. But in a way, it's an interesting fight at the late stage of the careers of two former world champions.
Yeah. I mean, you had some amazing nights with Amir along the journey. I mean, where does this compare in terms of size with, say, the Kotelnik, which we all remember? I mean, we were all there in Manchester.
Yeah, yeah.
Where does it compare with these types of fights?
Yeah, that's an interesting question. I think if both the fighters were at the prime, this would have probably been the top of the tree, in my opinion, even though he's had a different path on going down. After I left him, and he's done the Crawford fight, and he's done the Canelo fight, and so on and so forth. But I think from my opinion, if he'd ever done it, both of them had done it at the top of the tree, it would have been one of the great British fights of the century.
Yeah,
this century.
We know Kell Brook's really up for this fight. He's been calling for it a lot. Amir's stepped up now and this fight is on. Do you think Amir can get up for it to the same level that Kell can?
Knowing what I know in boxing, and both the lads, obviously, I've never worked with Kell before, but I've been so close making them fights at a time when I thought the timing was right. I think who's going to step up the most? Who wants it the most? They both want it the most. And I think they're both going to go in with a view of outdoing each other. But will it be a classico? I don't know. Will it be a one-punch knockout? I think it will, but it's going to be fatigue that's going to get them both. And whoever fatigues the less and carries on with their engine is the winner.
Do you think both of these fighters need a bit more credit from the public as well in just terms of what they've done in their careers before this fight? We know it's too late, this fight. But,
yeah,
you know, before that, you know, what they've done for the country and GB and the UK and Ireland, etc. Do you think they deserve a lot of credit for that?
I think they both do. And I think they've both been a credit to the country. And I think they've both done really, really well. Amir's done exceptionally well, as we know, in his career. Unfortunately, boxing is just not boxing anymore. Boxing, people look at boxing not just as a sport, but outside the sport, what people do. And they both made mistakes outside the sport. But within the boxing, you cannot knock them back. Kell's had a terrific career. He stepped up to game when he needed to step up. Amir's had an amazing career. He stepped up to the game when he needed to step up. Now, from me, both these guys should now finish it off. That's it. Don't fight after this because they're not, the health is more important. And you've got to have that stop. My plan with Amir was, and he always said this, he wanted to stop at 30. It's not 30 anymore. Obviously, COVID's got in the way, but you know, you now got children, both of them have got kids. Think about the families. Is money more important or is the career boxing more important? You've got to look at that moving forward.
Yeah, no, that's a fair point. And it sounds like you're split on the fight in terms of you think it's a real 50-50 fight. So I suppose that's why it's sold so much and it's a grudge match. But did you see either fighter having the edge or do you really see it as literally a 50-50?
No, I think both fighters have got the edge. Amir's got the speed and Kell's got the power. How long can Amir keep his speed up and when will Kell's power kick in? That's it. That is it. When will Amir Khan stop with his speed? And if he's going to stop within the first six, if he stops after six and seven rounds, Kell will kick in. And that's the game plan that I think if Amir keeps attacking his eye socket, which is a weak point, as we all know, and Kell attacks Amir and he can get caught within the first six, then will it go to the distance? I can't see it. To me, first seven rounds are Amir's, the rest of the rounds are Kel's. And whoever finishes off, Amir can do it in for the first seven and Kel can do it in the later stages. And that is it. There's no other way of doing it. I can't see it going any other way. But then again, this is boxing. Who knows?
Fair enough. Well, thanks for your thoughts on the fight anyway. There's a big, something big on the table for you. I mean, the Fight Zone platform, which started off and has gained momentum. It's put on some good shows and got a lot of prospects out as well and even some good title wins. How did your involvement with Fight Zone actually start?
Well, in fairness, I've known Dennis Hobson a very long time and it was just by chance, really. He phoned me up over the COVID period and said, you know, I'm from Bolton and he wants to put Jack Massey on for Bolton. Can I help him out? And I said, yeah, go on then. I'll help him out. And that's what I did. I helped him for the Jack Massey fight. And thankfully, he won that night. It was an amazing night of boxing. It was packed to the rafters. The credit wasn't given to Jack before the fight. The credit's still not given to Jack after the fight. And then I said, I had a sit down with Steve Crump and Dennis Hobson. And I said, listen, guys, you just need to take this at a different level. The way I've seen you guys perform over the 3 months that I helped them out, I come up with various plans and opportunities and presented them to them. And that's when we talked about the role. And I said, the only way it's going to go forward is a full on hands on control where I can bring my own teams in and take this forward. And that's what I did from Christmas onwards and January onwards. And you've seen the schedule and we're really kicking into it. And we've got a new way of working with Fight Zone. Fight Zone is an amazing platform to build fighters and it's an amazing platform to have champions on. Now, BT, Sky, DAZN, all the other platforms are there. Them platforms are there, but it's limited for what boxers can be. Here, Fight Zone will have live fights more or less every weekend or every other weekend. And the plan that we've got is fantastic. And it's an opportunity for fighters to box on a different platform as well as going out regularly. And that's one thing that's not been happening. Fighters going out regularly. And this is a platform that can happen.
You mentioned your role then, having a more of a controlling role. So, what is your actual role then going forward, Asif, in the Fight Zone organisation? And has it come at a good time for you where you were looking forward to a new boxing challenge as well?
Yeah, I fell out of love with boxing. Everybody knows that. I wasn't interested in boxing after the work with Tyson Fury. And I just didn't want to get into boxing anymore. I needed a break myself mentally. I've had to recoup myself after some personal incidents in my life. And when I got involved in the Jack Massey fight with Dennis, I got my flavour back and that's when the buzz started coming back and I thought, no, I can give a lot more into boxing. So the role of Fight Zone as a COO really, really got my juices flowing. And I've really grabbed it and grasped it. And even though you've not heard a lot going on the platform behind the scenes, I've been doing a lot of work. And I will be making an announcement before the 12th of Feb because the campaign that we are putting in, it just takes time to do. And I know the subscribers are there thinking what's going on, but wait, because it's very exciting. I'm hoping to have it done before next week. If I don't do it next week, then within 14 days before the 12th, there'll be a press release going out on what the campaign is going to be.
It sounds exciting. You've mentioned the schedule as well. I've looked at the schedule myself. Of course, there's a lot of fighters from the Northwest in there, so very, very excited on a personal level. But the schedule does pack in a lot of fights and a lot of fighters. So it is quite logistically a tough operation, this Fight Zone, because every week, every other week, there's a lot of fighters that can pull out and there's COVID tests and there's all sorts. But are you sort of enjoying that challenge side of it as well?
I think the challenges are always going to be there in boxing. What is difficult is when additional pressures and challenges get put in and you've got to find a way out of it. listen, January boxing got kiboshed, and in a way, I'm so glad because it gave me the opportunity to review everything that we had to do for Fight Zone. There's not been one fight on Fight Zone platform, and the subscribers are thinking, well, what's going on? But the way we've done the schedule, the way we're planning the next the schedule after that, and the way that we're going to go internationally, it's going to be a really good opportunity for the subscribers. And it will, like I say, I will be making a big announcement, and it will be something that the fight fans can access. And realistically, once I've reorganized the back end of Fight Zone, then we can push forward. And we're nearly there with it.
You know, you've been in boxing for decades and you've seen a lot internationally, nationally, everything. You know, where do you feel the boxing industry is at the minute? Do you feel that we're having a resurgence? Do you feel that there needs to be changes made? Do you feel we're in a good place? Where do you feel that we're at?
I think boxing itself is, there's twists and turns every month. I don't think you can say we're in a resurgence. I think COVID really struck home the boxing market. And for argument's sake, I've got matchmakers who's working for me on a full-time basis, and I've got other matchmakers as well. We can't make matches because some of the boxers haven't fought for 2 years, and the board is knocking the fighters back saying, well, it's not fair that person will go into that fight because that fighter's not fought for 2 years. But there's been something like COVID. So fighters have been inactive and they had to make the money elsewhere. So the lower end of the fighters who are potential haven't been getting out there. And they're the ones that are having difficulty getting back onto the platform. And they're the ones that have been having difficulty in resurging their careers. The top and the middle end of the boxers have had an opportunity to carry on and have had an opportunity to box on different platforms, but now it's tight because the zone and the way Eddie's working and the way Ben Shalom's working is different, and the way other platforms are doing boxing, and obviously Frank's doing his stuff on BT, and there's more fighter opportunities on app platforms like ours. But I think it just needs to open up a bit more because British Sport of Boxing needs to have a open policy now. World is changing. I know they want to protect the sport, and I know, but we've got to live with COVID, and we've just got to get crack on. And the sport needs to bring back the boxers that haven't had the opportunity over the last 2 years. Otherwise, we lose them all, and the new boxers, there's going to be a big gap in between the boxers, and that will be difficult.
Yeah, like a lost generation of boxers, really, yeah. With that being said, then, what's your actual ambition for the development of Fight Zone? You know, with your new input, like, where, if I could say to you, like, Fight Zone in a year or 2 years' time, do you have any grand visions of where it will be and the growth of Fight Zone?
Yeah, it's a good question. Like, yeah, I mean, the way we're looking at it, obviously, we're an app-based platform at the moment. However, there's no reason that we can't partner up with the mainstream broadcasters, because the amount of talents that we have on our roster is unbelievable. We've got world champions and all the way to area champions. I've never looking at the roster of champions that we have, and we've 17 champions and counting, and putting people in fights that they've never had the opportunity to do to fight, and these champions are coming forward, and people have stepped up like Jack Massey. Jack's got the world at his feet at the moment. He's a huge lad, and he can easily go into heavyweight, easy, and he can maybe make a stance there. And the heavyweight division is exciting, but it's also, there's no British talent that's coming through which can make a difference, and I believe Jack can make a difference in that division as well. Hannah Rankin, Scottish, the first woman, Scottish woman to have a two world weight champion. She's making moves, and obviously we've announced the big show in Brayhead. We're just tying up our opponent, and for an app-based company to go into Brayhead where there's going to be nearly 5,000 people, that's fantastic. We're giving people opportunities. We want Jack to fight on bigger platforms. We want Anna to fight on bigger platforms. And, you know, we have a huge talent of boxers that we can take forward. So we're lucky that we've the investments that's been done by Steve Cook and Dennis Hobson, we're lucky that Ross is there, and we're lucky that we can partner up with anybody and put good shows on.
Yeah, it does look like then that you guys have got a really good plan in place, and I'm excited to see what this year brings. I really appreciate your time. I know you know, you're a busy guy, so thanks for jumping on this Zoom with me. Is there anything you want to say on just on a final note to people who maybe haven't seen you for a while in the boxing arena and things like that?
Yeah, I'm glad to be back. I'm glad to you've seen all the press releases are going out. You know, bring in different vision. I always like to help the boys from the lower end. I always like to give them a platform. I always like to give them an opportunity, because talent in boxes is within that boxer. It's how they get managed, and it's how they are put forward on different platforms. We're open. Fight Zone is an open opportunity. We've got partner promotions, which are like Kevin Murrayport Promotions and Sam Kinnock Promotions, and we have partner promotions in place. So it's not just us. There's other partner promotions, and you know, there's nearly 800 boxers that are there. So just tune into Fight Zone. The new announcement, it's not going to cost you anything. The new announcement's coming out soon. Just tune in and see how we do. And if we do well, carry on watching it.
All right. Well, thank you very much for your time. And as I say, looking forward to the next developments. And I'm sure we'll see you at a show soon.
Yeah, look forward to seeing you soon, Aki. Thanks a lot.
Take care. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.